SpaceX has returned an upgraded Super Heavy booster to the factory, after an unexpected explosion and fireball caused minor damage during testing. CEO Elon Musk first revealed that the company would need to remove the rocket from Starbase's orbital launch pad for inspections and repairs on July 13, about a day and a half after the anomaly. Join us as we bring you, Fireball sends SpaceX Super Heavy booster back to the factory for upgrade, and when will Starship fly? On July 11, during what may have been a partial wet dress rehearsal, a dispersed cloud of methane gas found an accidental ignition source, and exploded with a force that at least one observer estimated was equivalent to several pounds of TNT. Several nail-biting hours of uncertainty followed, during which SpaceX attempted to empty Super Heavy Booster 7 of its propellant and explosive potential and regain control of the situation, while simultaneously trying to avoid stoking a fire that started at the pad. With a heaping serving of luck, Booster 7 made it through the event mostly intact. Now SpaceX must take a close appraisal of the rocket and situation, and decide how to proceed. Musk, as always, has put his optimistic face forward on Twitter and in a direct response to Reuters. According to an email sent shortly after an early in-person post-anomaly inspection, Musk stated that Booster 7 could return to the launch stand probably next week, implying that any damage suffered was extremely minor. By the time Super Heavy was removed from the launch mount the next day, however, it became clear that the situation wasn't quite as optimal. Instead, Booster 7's aft engine section was clearly damaged, with some of the dozens of thermal protection panels enclosing 33 Raptor engines, apparently torn off or knocked askew by the July 11th blast. Given the tight fit and relatively heavy-duty nature of some of those panels, deformation could easily damage some of the more sensitive plumbing and components on Raptor engines. The day prior, teams spent hours tearing out unexpectedly fragile components of Booster 7's hidden aft heat shielding and even removed and replaced one of its Raptors in situ. More likely than not, all Raptor engines with minor damage can be repaired and reused on a future booster. The explosion may also give SpaceX invaluable data that can be used to improve the durability and performance of Raptor and Super Heavy's heat shield. Nonetheless, a methodical inspection of Booster 7's aft end could easily take a week or two. If more chronic damage is discovered or the whole aft heat shield, or a large number of Raptors need to be removed and replaced, the hiatus could grow to a month or more. Following Booster 7's July 15th return to the Starbase factory, SpaceX appears to have begun removing more Raptor engines on July 17th, kicking off a phase that will hopefully be heavy on encouraging inspection results, and light on substantial repairs. If it turns out that the Super Heavy prototype is mostly in great shape, after such a violent anomaly, it would bode well for the rocket's durability during future ground and flight testing. If it did not fare well, SpaceX may need to seriously reconsider whether Booster 7 is fit to support Starship's orbital launch debut, or even proceed into static fire testing. Either way, SpaceX recently finished stacking Super Heavy Booster 8. If it's made a priority, the newest prototype could be made ready to take over, where Booster 7 left off within a few weeks. Alternatively, it could even join a repaired Booster 7 at the launch pad, for basic proof testing. While its predecessor attempts to restart its first static fire campaign. Simultaneously, Starship S-24 is almost ready to begin its own static fire test campaign. SpaceX is waiting for a spaceflight license from the Federal Aviation Administration to launch Starship to orbit this summer. It is unclear whether the explosion caused any damage that would potentially delay the long-awaited debut orbital flight test. Regarding the amount of damage the blast caused, Musk said that the base of the vehicle seems okay by flashlight. He wrote on July 12 at midnight, "I was just out there about an hour ago. We shut down the pad for the night for safety. We'll know more in the morning." Hours later, when the ship's remaining cryogenic fuel had been drained, Musk accompanied a team that made the initial damage assessment. Just after midnight local time on Tuesday, he tweeted the launch pad was off limits following the team's quick visit, to avoid potential lingering danger, base of the vehicle seems okay by flashlight. I was just out there about an hour ago. We shut down the pad for the night for safety. We'll know more in the morning. Rocket science ain't easy. Further tweets from Musk give the impression the problem was caused by an accumulation of unburned propellant expelled from the 33 Raptor 2 engines that will power Starship boosters into space. Musk reminded his followers engineering a launch vehicle is never a simple task. Cryogenic fuel is an added challenge, as it evaporates to create fuel air explosion risk in a partially oxygen atmosphere like Earth. Responding to a follower, who wondered if it would be prudent to follow NASA's example, during the space shuttle era. The agency used radial outward firing igniton to set off escaped fuel. Before it could accumulate, Musk said SpaceX will do the same. He also said SpaceX's technicians may have overdone it with this particular test. That is one of the things we will be doing going forward. This particular issue, however, was specific to the engine spin start test. Raptor has a complex start sequence. Going forward, we won't do a spin start test with all 33 engines at once. Since SpaceX is returning after having already shown the Raptor mounts, we will be testing SpaceX further if there are no major issues, and our next goal is to include the new Raptor engine in the B-7 prototype. The block lies on the ground with clear markings, but the design of the new compartments did not allow amateurs, with cameras to get a good idea of the accelerators being developed. But 2 weeks later, things seem to be different with SpaceX. The team appears to have an enclosed shroud that will simultaneously protect the Raptor's booster 7 and engine parts during electrostatic fire testing. The shroud also protects the engine during re-entry and landing if the B-7 can get there, but Musk later confirmed that the team had a reverse osmosis engine installed. Now, when will Starship fly? While there was no set date for the first orbital test flight of Starship, the company had touted a target of as early as this month. With the assessment of damage to Booster 7 still underway, when Starship will finally circle the Earth for the first time is even more unclear. It may be that damage to Booster 7, which is designed to withstand the rigors of being the most powerful rocket ever built, may have come out relatively unscathed and easily repaired. Or it could be totaled, and if that is the case, SpaceX has other super heavy lift boosters in various stages of completion that could replace the damaged rocket ship. The Everyday Astronaut website maintains a calendar of events and expected milestones relating to Starship's FAA approval and initial orbital flight. It still lists July as a possibility for liftoff. A fuel explosion interrupted a static engine test of SpaceX's Starship super heavy lift vehicle. The accident could delay this summer's orbital test flight. Musk's claims about what will happen after that rocket is ready are even loftier. According to Musk, after SpaceX is done preparing a Starship and Super Heavy booster for their inaugural orbital launch attempt sometime next month. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.